watching the Art Fair Spring Facebook page. We're about to begin the celebration of the 5 p.m. vigil mass for the first Sunday of Advent. A reminder for anyone who can pray with us in the parking lot at convenient time, a minister will come out to the covered walkway to distribute communion to anyone praying with us from the parking lot. At that time, please step forward and receive communion, and then return to your vehicle for the remainder of this celebration. For anyone who can come forward, once those who are able have done so, then please drive up to the covered walkway, and a minister will bring communion to you while you're in your vehicle. Again, then simply return to your spot in the parking lot for the remainder of this celebration. Thank you, and we will begin.
Okay, it's candles of the gospel.
Once again, good evening, everyone, and welcome. Let's stand and sing together, "Wake, O Wake, and Sleep No Longer," and it's number 56 in our new breaking bread.
To you I lift up my soul, O my God, in you I have trusted. Let me not be put to shame, nor let my enemies exult over me, and let none who hope in you be put to shame. Wake and sleep no longer.
great anticipation, we gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Indeed, our God has promised to send us a Savior. As we prepare to celebrate the coming of Christ in time, the return of Christ in glory, let us call to mind our sins and so prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Kyrie eleison. Christ Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christe eleison. Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us for everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. You, Lord, are our Father, our Redeemer. You are named forever. Why do you let us wander, O Lord, from your ways, and harden our hearts so that we hear you not? Return for the sake of your servants, the tribes of your heritage. Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down with the mountains quaking before you. While you wrought awesome deeds we cannot hope for, such as they have not heard of from of all. No ear has ever heard, no eye ever seen any God but you doing such deeds for those who wait for him. Would that you might meet us doing right, that we were mindful of you in our ways. Behold, you are angry, and we are sinful. All of us have become like unclean people. All our good deeds are like polluted rags. We have all withered like leaves, and our guilt carries us away like the wind. There is none who calls upon your name, who rouses himself to cling to you, for you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us up to our guilt. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay, and you the potter. We are all the work of your hands. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account. For the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you are enriched in every way, with all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you are called to fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The readings we hear proclaimed this night, they're not foreign to us, despite the fact that they are readings that we really only hear once every 3 years. Here's when the Gospel of Mark is read to us. And that time of year when we kick off, if you will, the season of Advent in particular. Now, admittedly, this particular gospel passage has some pretty natural themes to it, all flowing from the powerful words of the Lord in Mark's gospel. Be watchful, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. Adding to this a very short story, and then, of course, with a strong directive at the conclusion of this passage from Jesus, what I say to you, I say to all, watch. So naturally, I think, if you're like me, you walk away from hearing this proclamation, either desiring to hear more about the what it is that you, that me, that that others are being told and being directed to be watchful, be alert, to not be caught sleeping. Just what is it we are to watch for? Now, not trying to ruin the ending, kind of like, you know, when you see a movie for the first time with a friend who's seen it before and who blurts out what the ending is, but the reality is that there's not getting around the fact Jesus is telling his hearers then, just as he tells us, his hearers, now, that I'm going to come back, and you need to be ready for that. So, of course, the greatest challenge remains our, perhaps, unconscious desire to at least know, well, when is this going to happen, since this has been proclaimed as something we're called to believe in for over 2,000 years, and it hasn't happened yet. We need to know. We want to know. We're busy people, after all. Our calendars are full. There's no wiggle room in the day to add one more thing. It's kind of like the Circle Fest and Parade of Lights. Don't just tell me when the Circle Fest is going to happen. I need more details, more specifics, so that I can be among the few hundred fellow Talmadge citizens who have their spots on the circle set up at least as early as noon the day of the fest. Despite the fact the Parade of Lights doesn't really happen until somewhere around 9 p.m. I believe it's safe to say that we have somewhat of a handle on what it is to be watchful for, that is, to be alert for. Perhaps what we leave out is just how we are to watch, how we are to be alert. Now, I'm going to suggest that not only the gospel passage we've heard this weekend addresses this fairly clearly, but so does the opening collect, the opening prayer. Grant your faithful servants the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. My friends, in other words, to be watchful, to be alert, we need to be actively engaged in the purpose Jesus Christ has called each of us to. We need to be doing our job, our work. After this man places his servants in charge of the home while he goes on a journey, expecting each to do their own work while he's gone, it's the gatekeeper that's given the final assignment. Be on the watch. That was the purpose of the gatekeeper. Do your job. Serve your purpose. Don't sit idly by nor doze off and fall asleep. Do what you need to do so that when I return, everything will be in good order. All will be protected. Everything will be ready. It was the gatekeeper's responsibility to watch over the master's house while he and his family were away, and to be watchful and alert so that when they returned, the gatekeeper would readily open the door for them. Most of the time, he would return, and he could expect that return, but not an extremely precise time. So there's still responsibility for the gatekeeper to be watchful and alert for extended periods of time. To not just fall asleep, but readily open that door. To not do that would be to fail in his responsibility. My friends, you and I have a purpose. We're called to be gatekeepers, to be watchful and alert for the Lord's return in glory, striving to do so by the lives continually engaged in righteous deeds. You and I have a purpose. To be watchful and alert for the Lord's return in glory and readily let him in. His coming in time set in motion the act of redeeming all that the Father has entrusted to him. And so we're called to be watchful and alert for the Lord, who every moment of every day wants to enter into our lives, into our minds, into our hearts. He wants to be with us, present to us, care for us, love us, and shape us, and fashion us anew, like the clay in the hands of the potter. And this happens each and every time we enter into our purpose. To be watchful and alert is to be aware of who we are and whose we are. Now certainly awareness can be a function of fear, but also of love. If being redeemed and fully and completely is our final end with Jesus in his mission, and that was his mission to redeem us, to bring us all back to the hands of the potter, the creator, then so be it, for that will be God's final revelation of God's creative love. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten. May the anticipation of our spirits, the deepest longings of our hearts, and the hope of all humanity be given voice in prayer this night.
We pray, God of Isaiah, that your church, grasping the urgency of the hour, may be the clay you desire, so as to fashion this people into the work of your hands. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, God of every nation, that the family of humankind may work together to turn swords into plows for the good of all people, especially in Ukraine, Israel, Palestine, and portions of Africa and the Americas, and wherever violence and war rage. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, God of peace, that all who suffer the devastation of terror, violence, and war may once again hear the strength of your voice and see the power of your deeds of love and peace for all people. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, God of justice, that all who work for justice may inspire others to deeds that are just and good. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, God of hope, that all who suffer may find strength in your love and care, especially the victims and survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church, and these we pray for, by name: Kelly Castle, John Chargarina, Agnes Clark, Mary Dunkey, Danny Firth, Floss Firth, Daisha Fermi, Robert Jayette, Julian Jenkins, Dan Lane, Tom Larkowski, Beth Mariola, Lynn Manningly, Kay Maglek, Chloe Pasco, Carol Scaly, George Servant Jr., Paula Simmons, Kaylin Tafini, Giovanni Testa, Mary Testa, Tina Testa. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, God of all truth, that inquirers, catechumens, and candidates in our church may be awake to your presence and continue to walk in the light of your ways along with candidates for confirmation and Eucharist. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, God, of the poor and the lowly, that our community of faith may be attentive to your word and always gather in the joyful hope and expectation of your Son's coming, and that any who have strayed from you may again gather with us around the table of your Son. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, God, of the promise that all who have recently died, Daniel Ray Sr., as well as Jim Morkowski, for whom this Mass is being offered, and all the dead, may find eternal rest on your holy mountain. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, on this, the day that you have made, we wait with anticipation for the return of your Son. Hear us as we pray these things and all things in his name, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
My friends, as we continue this celebration of the vigil for the first Sunday of Advent, we also mark it with an annual blessing and lighting of the wreath. So let us turn to the God of hope and the God of promise. Lord God, your church joyfully awaits the coming of its Savior who enlightens our hearts. Dispels the darkness of ignorance and sin. Pour forth your blessings upon us as we light the candle of this wreath. May its light reflect the splendor of Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory chant, we sing together, Waiting in Silence, and it's number 51.
Thank you.
fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Waiting in silence, waiting in hope, we are.
Friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death. For you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior. Made incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary, he shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery which he himself left us as an everlasting covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church. Grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered in one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis our Pope, Edward our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There with the whole of creation, free from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
your spirit. Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
chant fixing beyond the moon and stars. That's number 48.
Thank you.
mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. Even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
As we always do, thank all who give of their time and their talent to support your church's mission and ministry, especially over the past several weeks. You know, this doesn't happen with, you know, just a few folks. So the Art and Environment Committee certainly has been very active. I especially want to thank, too, our youth. Last night, Amy Bachnick, Nicole Cochran, and Katie Patton. Nicole and Amy kind of organized it. Katie Patton was one of the adults that helped. But we probably had anywhere from a dozen to just a little under two dozen youth who changed out all those song booklets. So I just, and they had fun. And while they were doing that, I was busy because the Advent wreath imploded, and so we were trying to hold pillars and things like that. And they were having a good time, and with their help, so they didn't notice right away. But that's okay. That's okay. So anyhow, thank you. Thank you to those who give of your treasure to support your parish's mission and ministry. Don't forget your bulletins. Take fives or at the entrances of the church. There are plentiful Advent resources. Don't be without those on tables near the entrances. We ask a free will offering, with the exception of breaking bread, which is what is in your pews. There is an envelope with a specific amount that we ask for, so just place that in the envelope and put that in the collection box or send it over to the care center. Get it to us. Again, a thank you to those who have helped so much. A reminder, the deadline for Christmas gift giving is this is next Sunday, December 10th. Thank you to those who have already done so. Do remember that it's convenient, you can give online via Faith Direct. This Wednesday, we have evening prayer and Eucharistic exposition in church at 7 p.m. We hope that you will join us, especially in this parish year of Eucharistic revival. Also a reminder, at the conclusion of the 8:30 a.m. Mass this Thursday, we will begin 24 hours of exposition of the Blessed Sacrament, and that will conclude prior to the start of the 8:30 a.m. Mass on Friday, December 8th, which is the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, our 79th anniversary of the founding of this parish, and we begin our 80th year, which we are very excited about. There's still, a thank you to those who have signed up to keep watch, there's still a few openings, so we printed the sheets just of the times that are open, and they're on tables near the entrance of the church. So if you would kindly sign up, we do need to have all that covered, so thank you again. Don't forget, Parish School Religion folks, the Knights of Columbus Keep Christ in Christmas poster contest. The deadline for submission is tomorrow, December 3rd. So, you know, if you're like me, when I took high school physics, I had all year to do my project. I went to the library the night before and stayed up all night and drew a chart. So don't do that, and don't do that. Put thought into what you're going to do. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May the Almighty and Merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son, and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent, and enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
As you run the race of this present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity.
Amen.
So that, rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
And let's sing again soon and very soon, and it's number 580.